presence with you. The first one happened a long time ago. In fact, years went by before I even realized God's hand in the situation. Back in 1983, Dale was hired as a herdsman by a wonderful couple who lived on Highway 26. We moved there with our two children, Ryan and Aaron, and became members of this church. We were a perfect fit for the farm and really enjoyed our new home. Dale worked very hard and within less than a year began working his way into the farm to eventually take it over entirely. After a couple of really rough years, we thought things were really turning around for us and the future was looking pretty bright. Then in June of 1984, a barn fire happened. It was a total loss, but we were able to save the cows. Over the next year, Dale milked remotely at two different locations, trying to keep the business alive. But by spring of 1985, the decision was made not to rebuild the barn on the home farm and to sell the herd. Back to square one. Dale was lucky enough to find a new herdsman job in Waupun, and we moved there in April of 85. Son number three, Nathan, was born a month later. We were in Waupun for a couple of years until October of 87, at which time we moved to where we presently live on Fairview Road, as a new herdsman job had opened up in that area. A few weeks after we had moved into our home, we were blessed with our fourth child, Krista. Occasionally, we would talk about how different things might have been if that barn fire wouldn't have happened. How we would be the owners of a beautiful dairy farm on Highway 26 by now, and happily raising our four children. Why did God allow that barn fire to happen? After all, at the time, the cause of the fire had been ruled an act of God, as lightning had struck the elevator that was going up into the barn. Now, fast forward to Monday, September 24th, 1996. The kids all got ready for school as usual, although buses were running a little late because of a dense fog in the area. Tragedy struck. The headlines in the paper the next day read, "Five die when rig rear-ends a car and a school bus on Highway 26. The flag at Laconia High School was flying at half staff in memory of a 15-year-old boy who had been sitting in the back of the bus that had been ripped open by the semi. It was a horrible accident, and many were traumatized for a long time. Over a dozen years had passed since the barn fire had happened, but I finally realized God's plan, because if it hadn't been for the fire and the journey our life took after it, the boys sitting in the back of the bus could have very well been Aaron and Ryan. Praise and thanks to God." Now I gotta breathe. Okay. Now, on to God moment number two, which happened just a few months ago. I will remember Monday, October 12th, 2020, for the rest of my life. It started out as a normal beginning to another week. I had to be to work by 10 a.m., so I had left the house around 9:30. I was traveling east on County Road T. As you all know, County Road T has quite a few curves in it until you get past Y. Well, I never got past Y that morning. I was approaching a curve, and I noticed that someone was going to pull out of his driveway onto T. I watched him to make sure he saw me coming and that he was going to wait for me. Well, my eyes were watching him. My vehicle, a 2016 Buick Encore, left the road. As soon as it hit the gravel along the side of the road, I got sucked in, and I couldn't get my car back onto the road. I hit the side of a driveway for machinery to enter a field, which propelled my car straight up into the air, missing a telephone pole by inches. The car crashed down onto the back end and then rolled end to end and then side to side before coming to rest on all four wheels in the field. So, there's my car. What used to be my car. Dale watched as they loaded my car onto the flatbed, and he said that 3 out of the 4 wheels fell off at that time. After my car had come to rest, every airbag in the vehicle had gone off, and I noticed smoke coming from the dash and the steering wheel. My first thought was, get out, the car's on fire. Well, I didn't know at the time that when your airbag is deployed that smoke comes out of the steering wheel area, which is what it was, but I didn't know that. So anyway, I unbuckled my seatbelt and opened my door, and as my door opened, a hand came in, and it was the man who was pulling out of his driveway who had watched the whole thing. He helped me out of my car. His wife had already called 911. Within minutes, I had the fire department, police, and EMTs by my side, most of which knew my name. Soon the ambulance arrived. I walked with assistance through the field and through the ditch to the side of the road where I sat on the stretcher from the ambulance. I was transported to St. Agnes Hospital, where I spent the next few hours getting x-rays and scans done to be sure that there was nothing broken and no internal bleeding. I still had not seen Dale, as he was not allowed into the hospital because of COVID, and the ambulance had left the scene before Dale had gotten there because he was at work in Oshkosh when it happened. Well, as things turned out, I had a bruise on my abdomen where the seatbelt was, and a large hematoma or bruise on my upper left arm. There's probably still a little smiley face there of a bruise left to this day, which is, what, 4 months later now? And that was probably caused by the airbag, the arm one. I had a wonderful police officer who had served as a link between Dale and I while I was in the emergency room. He relayed information from the ER to Dale about my condition, and then would come back in and tell me things that Dale wanted me to know. This officer, plus the EMTs and the firefighters on the scene, plus the EMTs in the ambulance, plus the doctors and nurses in the ER, all told me what a lucky girl I was to walk away from an accident that traumatic with only bruises. The officer said I was lucky to have such a well-built car that was able to protect me during a rollover both ways. And to some extent, I agree that my Buick was built well and did protect me. That's why we got another one. But I also know that there's not a vehicle on the face of this earth that's strong enough to protect you when it comes time for you to go to your eternal home. God wasn't ready for me yet. I guess he decided that there were more things that he wanted me to accomplish in this earthly life before he calls me to my heavenly home. I truly feel that I look for these opportunities now more than ever. On October 12th, I had more than a well-built car protecting me. I'm sure there were a few guardian angels present too. Now, thanks to a gift sent from Kristen, I have this hanging in my new Buick. I think it says on the bottom, "Angels watch over us." So what have I learned from all this? I don't have a crystal ball, and none of us have an expiration date stamped on our foot. But living and loving would be a good start. Sharing and taking care of our neighbors as you would like them to care for you. Making strong family bonds and understanding that family is a link to our past and a bridge to our future. And to make every moment in this earthly life count until we move on to the heavenly life that God has promised. He is in charge, and only He knows when our earthly time is over. We hear this in tonight's scripture reading from Ecclesiastes 3. There's a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heavens. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to search and a time to give up. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. What do workers gain from their toil? I have seen the burden God has laid on the human race. He has made everything beautiful in His time. He has also set in the human heart, yet no one can fathom. He's also set eternity in the human heart, yet no one can fathom what God has done from the beginning to end. I know that there is nothing better for people than to be happy and to do good while they live, that each of them may eat and drink and find satisfaction in all their toil. This is the gift of God. I know that everything God does will endure forever. Nothing can be added to it, and nothing taken from it. Please join me in the sermon song, In His Time.